The punch subsidy FG may deduct 2.4 trillion naira palliative from Federation account, plans talks. Page 2, the punch newspapers this morning, and the riders here. States provide list of 42 million beneficiaries of 5,000 naira legis monthly. Government must fix refineries before removing subsidy. Pangasin insists.
We're back there again today.
Yes, yeah.
I told you yesterday that they're going to be an unending one because, I mean, people are still trying to, just like the Okezie story, people are still wondering what 5,000 naira will do. You know, somebody has said it's not a palliative. You don't give somebody 5,000 naira and say you have solved the problem. It's not a palliative. It doesn't solve any problem. And these 40 million people you are even targeting, it's not transport allowance for them because they don't need transport. They probably don't go anywhere. They are very poor of the poor. They're very poor, you know. So it's really not a palliative. Find another thing to do in this argument of removing subsidy. And I think there's already a collective agreement among Nigerians that we are not saying we'll remove subsidy, but make the conditions, you know, for removing subsidy worth it. For instance, fix the refineries, get petrol working locally again, and then you can go and do your business of removing subsidy, because subsidy have found to be ineffective, inefficient, you know. And the government argument again, like the World Bank, is it only benefits mostly the rich anyway. The rich already can afford petrol, but they're buying it for cheap, you know. If you need subsidy, that will be resolved. That this is the argument of the people who are pushing for removal of subsidy. Nigerians are not saying no, but they're saying it will impoverish more Nigerians now, given the state of the country now, the weight of inflation, the biting difficulty in this country, the total hardship across all sectors. Everything is expensive. Today on our tour as food security, we'll come to it, that you see that Nigerians are indeed really, really suffering. You know, so this is the continuous argument. But Minister Zainab Ahmed, her office, again said yesterday that even though the Senate says it wasn't appropriated, you know, that they will take the 2.4 trillion for a year, you know, from the deducted from the Federation account and disburse it to 42 to 43 million Nigerians. According to them, there's a national social register in the Office of the National Social Investment Program, you know, that was identified up to 40 million Nigerians as we speak. And that by December, they hope that they will even have been able to register 43 million in all. So the plan is that, the argument is that who are these 40 million? It's just a baseless argument. There are 40 million identified, more than 40 million identified poor Nigerians who will benefit from this disbursement of 5,000 naira a month for a year, you know. Again, what happens after the 1 year? Because the way I say it, if the government intends to remove subsidy and pay 5,000 and it's not forever, it's for a year, there's like severance package, you know, for the subsidy scheme to go. But a lot of experts have said it's a waste of money. You know, and Labour has also insisted that you can't even do this. Our talks are still ongoing. It's a raw Peter to paper situation. We do not agree with it. It's an unnecessary gamble, you know, and all that. Chris Ngigi, the Minister for Labour, also added his voice. In fact, he's saying something different. He's saying that the removal of subsidy is not a punishment for Nigerians, and that already, as we speak, nothing has even been decided. Talks with Labour are still ongoing. Talks are continuing, Mr. Chris Ngigi has said. And then he also said that even if subsidy is removed, the government has a scheme to provide palliative safety nets, to provide palliatives for Nigerians. This is Mr. Chris Ngigi. So when you hear him speak, you know that he already knows what will happen. He's just trying to not preempt it, you know, because in one breath he says nothing has been decided, and then he goes on and say even if it happens, they are palliatives. You know? So he's already speaking like Zainab Ahmed, the Minister of Finance. Mm-hmm. Inevitably, subsidy will have to go. The NNPC have said we cannot carry this burden anymore.
Boko Haram has ready tools from today's 14 million out-of-school children. Boko Haram has ready tools from today's 14 million out-of-school children. That's according to former President Olusegun Obasanjo. Story is on page 8 of the Punch newspaper this morning.
Yeah. It's a social crisis that Obasanjo has identified. That if it continues like this in most parts of the North, and almost everywhere in the North today, where the amount of out-of-school children is rising astronomically year by year. I mean, we saw the UNICEF report, yes, 2 days ago, Diako. It's a damning verdict on the education situation in Northern Nigeria. Damning verdict. Nobody goes to school anymore, you know, in that place. You know, children ready for school, ripe and ready for school, of school age, don't go to school. You know, the ones that go are probably threatened by insecurity, so they stay at home. and Obasanjo is telling us, and we need to listen to him, that these are ready-made tools for insurgents, for Boko Haram, ISWAP, and bandits. Because, and I do mind, this is devil's workshop. Once these kids come off, once they turn teenage, 13, 14, 15, with no education and nothing to do,
what are you going to do with
them? They will just join the Boko Haram gangs, you know, and begin to pillage and murder all the way until they are killed or arrested, or until they are tired, and they will come and repent, and the government will absorb them into a program that pirated them back into the Boko Haram again. A vicious cycle.
Terrible one.
Did you enjoy this video? Hit the subscribe button for more, leave a comment, and like. Thank you.